The farmers are digging holes underground near River Nanduget to get water for irrigating their crops using rudimentary methods like scooping from the hole using jerrycans.
Hey.
Others are using minimal mechanized manual means of pumping, while others are using small solar-powered pumps. It is unbelievable that the soils on which the short-stunted shrub vegetation is growing can be turned into a productive agricultural land in this part of the region. The greatest challenge so far is water to help their crops survive the hot, scorching sun that the region is known for. Paul Lomongin, a farmer, wants to water his garden morning and evening. The semi-mechanized pumps are not meeting this demand. They do not pump water to the further ends of the garden. Emmanuel Musao is the Amudat Sub-County Agricultural Officer. He says the pests are manageable, but the water situation remains dire.
When we went to that garden, as you saw, I saw those challenges of pumps, the challenges of diseases, pests and diseases. So that's why I called him to come and immediately start on the issue of helping those farmers' groups to control pests and diseases, because that is within our reach.
Jacob Morris Kemo is a community-based trainer with ZOA, a non-government organization that runs projects to benefit the community. He wants the government to support the farmers by providing tanks to store water, especially for the dry seasons. Noro sub-county, another farmer, John Sirike, is struggling to maintain his tomato garden after his water source dried up.
The big challenge is water. These tomatoes mostly are lacked water for a period of 1 month. Then I struggled to construct a small dam there. Water has got finished within 1 month.
The chief administrative officer is content that the people are finally embracing government programs to bring about development in the area. There is still, however, a lot more work to be done. Most residents enjoy sitting about in the towns without engaging in any productive activities, which worries government officials like Waswa.
If you were cattle milk producers in this area, you could even open roads without government. You would even build your community schools without government, because development is out of surplus production.
But he hopes that the good work ethic of the few, who are mostly women, will soon spread to the many. He says the government will provide the pesticides and water tanks so farmers can prepare for the dry season.